Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be reviewing, swatching, and applying Flower Beauty blushes. I've got four different shades that I'll be talking about today, as well as their formulation and how they go on and all of that good stuff. So today we're going to be diving in to see how they perform and how they look and whether or not they are worth the money and worth the hype. Now, Flower Beauty was started by Drew Barrymore, if you guys don't know that, and I'm actually really intrigued by the brand. I will be doing a full face of Flower Beauty products in the near future, but I decided to start my Flower Beauty journey with blushes. This video is not sponsored. I bought all these with my own money. This is not like a promotional video or anything like that. I'm just curious to know more about the brand and more about these products. These blushes cost $10 per blush, and you do get 6 grams of product in each blush. If you told me you get 6 grams of blush, I'd be like, I don't know how much that is. Is that a lot? Is that a little? It's actually kind of like a standard amount from just opening up my blush drawer and just seeing how much product you get from different brands. It's kind of like a higher medium average amount you get. And I also want to mention that these blushes got Allure 2017 Beauty Award, that red sticker. So just kind of an FYI, they are accepted and loved by Allure. So that's one of the reasons, again, I wanted to give them a try, because they are supposed to be amazing and super beautiful blushes for a reasonable price. So anyway, that's a few quick things I wanted to mention just so you know how much they cost and all that stuff. And now let's jump into the application and then the swatches and then the final review. The colors that I'm going to be applying on my face today, and yes, I said colors plural because I'll be applying two to show you how at least two colors go on my skin. I'll be swatching all of them, but I figured I would apply only two, because if I start to apply four, I might look a little crazy. All right, so for the two colors, I'm gonna go with Sweet Pea, and I'm also going to be going with Warm Hibiscus. These are really, really popular. I'm gonna take my blush brush and I'm gonna dip this into a color called Sweet Pea, which is a nice desaturated, almost like a purpley pink color. I absolutely love this color if you're looking for kind of like a natural glow from within, like I'm actually blushing. So I'm going to apply this on this side. These blushes have an absolutely beautiful consistency. They're really light and very fine, and they go on beautifully and effortlessly, yet they're also very, very pigmented and really easy to work with at the same time. So honestly, as far as the formulation, I can't think of a better formula than these blushes. All right, I'm gonna stop. Take the brush away from me. So this was a matte color. Now on the other side, I'm going to be using a color that's called Warm Hibiscus, and it's essentially a shimmery version of this color right here, the Sweet Pea color. It's basically like a pink color with gold shimmers in it, and it reminds me a lot of a certain NARS blush. I'm gonna dip my brush into this one right here. Now this is the only shimmery blush in the collection. So if you only like shimmery, sheeny type of blushes, then this is kind of the only one you can go with. But I will say that even the matte ones, they don't make you look dull or just like flat. They go on beautifully. And even though they don't have a sheen, they don't make you look unhealthy or just too matte or just, oh, they don't do that at all. So don't be worried about that. And honestly, I prefer matte blushes personally, because if you have any texture going on with your cheeks or wherever you're applying your blushes, I'm assuming you're applying them on your cheeks, sometimes shimmery blushes can accentuate that texture. Most of the time, in fact, they tend to accentuate that texture, which for me is not ideal, because I most of the time tend to have some sort of a thing going on with my cheeks. So you can see that it's pretty much the same color, except this one right here has a sheen to it. It's got gold glitter sparkles in the blush, and then this one right here is matte, and then this one right here has got some bling to it. But yeah, so I just wanted to show you how they go on, and you can see that they're really pigmented. It's really easy to apply them, even though they do have that nice color payoff. It's not like you go like this and it's, whoa, too much, or whoa, it's patchy. They're not patchy. They're so easy to work with. They blend into the skin like no one's business, and they look beautiful. They honestly give you that like glow from within if you don't apply too much. I think I kind of overdid it a little bit with the blush because I went a little crazy, but again, if you apply the right amount, you will have a beautiful, beautiful finish with these blushes, which thank goodness, because I kind of got all four at the same time and I was like, I hope they're good. I hope they're as good as I've heard they are, because I'm going all in on these and I'm so happy I did. Since I am doing my makeup right now, I'm also going to apply a little bit of highlighter. I'm going to use Laura Geller highlighter in Gilded Honey. I'm kind of obsessed with this. I am going to be reviewing more products from Flower Beauty. They also have a highlighter palette that I'm really curious to get my hands on, but I don't have that at the moment, so I'm going to be using a different brand. So I'm just quickly going to apply a little bit of highlighter. Can't say that I don't have enough bling on my face now. Last time I did a blush review, I got a couple comments saying like, oh, you did too much of blush. So now I'm like, did I do too much? Did I not do too much? I don't know. But you know what? It's a blush review. I want you to see the blush. So here we go. We're just gonna look at this right now. I'm gonna zoom you guys in to show you how the blush is sitting on my skin. Honestly, like, it's so fine and it blends so well into the skin. It doesn't sit on the skin. It just like gives you color, gives you that sheen if you're using the warm hibiscus color. But it does not actually sit on top of the skin. It doesn't really give itself away. That's why it looks so natural and so beautiful. But yet it does give you that pow, that impact. All right, let's talk about the swatches now, shall we? So the first color I'm going to talk about is called Peach Primrose. And it's a beautiful peachy color, as the name suggests. It was actually one of the first colors I got. And when I looked at it in person, I was like, ooh, I don't know how it's gonna look like on my skin. It looks kind of orangey. You know, I wasn't sure about it, but I'll tell you what, when I wore it, it looked absolutely beautiful. It did not look orangey. It just kind of worked with my bronzer and looked beautiful. If you're worried about wearing kind of like an orangey color, don't be afraid with this specific one, because I think that it's really wearable and it looks really pretty on the skin. If you like warmer type blushes, this one is a great one. The next color I have is called Wild Rose, and this is a bright Barbie pink color, or maybe like a bubblegum color. It's just a bright pink color. Don't be afraid of this color. Again, when I first saw this, I was like, I don't know how I'm gonna do with this one. I'm not a huge fan of pink color on my face, like bright pink color. It just doesn't always look right, because I have a lot of yellow undertone to my skin and pink color doesn't always look right. But anyway, when I wore this, it looked beautiful, because again, you can choose how much coverage and how much brightness you want. So this is a bright color. If you just want a little bit of pink to your cheeks, you can just apply a little bit. If you want more, you can apply more, but this color is surprisingly wearable. Okay, so the next color is the one I applied. It's called Sweet Pea, and like I said, it's a beautiful nude pink color. It's a desaturated pinky violet color, which again, like, it looks like this in the packaging, but when you apply it on the skin, it looks obviously not the same, because when you're applying blush, you're not going to be like literally taking this color and just like applying this on your skin. It's only going to be a sheer overlay, a wash of color. So you have to think like, what does your bronzer look like? What does the skin underneath look like? And then how does that going to look like when you mix a little bit of this color on top? And for me, it looks like this. But anyway, I love this color because it does have that coolness to it. So when I apply this on my skin, you can still see a little bit of pink showing through. Now, this color here, I thought originally, is one I already have by Milani. And the color by Milani I thought was a dupe would be Romantic Rose. So I thought these two colors were dupes when I first bought this right here, because I was like, well, I have a nude pink color by Milani. But when I compare them together, they're totally not the same color. This one right here is like a desaturated red color, and this one right here is like a desaturated pinky violet color. So this one is a lot warmer than this one right here. Another reason why I thought this was a dupe is that the packaging is actually quite similar, but you actually get a lot more product in the Milani, just an FYI. You get 17 grams as opposed to 6 grams for the same price. So you actually get 3 times the amount of product in Milani as you do in Flower Beauty. So technically, if you take the same size of Flower Beauty as you would in Milani, Flower Beauty blush will cost $30 for the same size of the Milani blush. So it's a lot more expensive. Even though I love the Milani blushes, I actually think that Flower Beauty blushes are better because they have a finer formula and they blend into the skin better than the Milani ones do. I feel like these ones here, they tend to be a little bit crumbly and just larger consistency. So they kind of sit on top of the skin more than these ones do. So even though this one is cheaper, I actually don't think it's as good. However, I still love it and I still use it, but technically I do think that Flower Beauty is better. The last color is called Warm Hibiscus, and this is the only shimmery color in the collection. The other three colors are matte. This one has gold shimmers in it. It's really similar, like I showed you earlier, to the color called Sweet Pea, which is a desaturated pink color, but this one has shimmers and this one is a matte color. This is a beautiful color and reminds me a lot of the NARS blush, the O blush, if you know what I mean. You can say I like it a lot because it's pretty much gone, but this is really, really similar. And the NARS blush is 4.8 grams. This one is 6 grams. This one is like roughly $30. This one is roughly $10. So you get more product and it's one-third of the price. If you like this color but don't want to spend the money on the NARS blush, or maybe you're just looking for a similar blush of your favorite NARS blush, because this is really, really popular because it's so flattering and it looks so good on so many different skin tones. And this one right here is basically a dupe. So ultimately, I want to say that I absolutely love these blushes. I was pleasantly surprised with how wonderful they are. I love these blushes. I love the formula. I love the color. I think they are so worth the money. So if you had to pick one color, I would probably go with either Sweet Pea or Warm Hibiscus, because I think these colors are universally flattering and I think that you're gonna love them. But honestly, all the colors here are beautiful and I'm happy I have all of them. So that is it for my video. I hope you guys have found this helpful. Thank you so much for sticking around and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.